Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to add a mirror to your 350Z with a compass. I'm not sure how many of you guys follow me on Instagram, but I recently worked on a 2016 Audi R8. I know, I'm sorry, I didn't have time to do a video on it. There's so much work to do radar detector that I just didn't have time to film any of it. But what I noticed in the car was it had a mirror with a compass built in. Now, this is nothing new, but it kind of bugged me that the G35 has a compass in its display and the 350Z has like everything but. So I did some research, and good old Gentex, this seems to be the manufacturer that makes mirrors for everyone with compasses and other controls, makes one for other Nissans, and we're going to put this into our 350Z. There are two variations of this mirror. Now I have the more updated one. Now the version before this will have the antenna actually over here. So this portion that mounts your windshield will be bulkier if you have the older version. Also, this light sensor over here, it is going to be not covered. You can see there's a little cover on this guy. So those are the giveaways. So I'm going to put the parts in the description below in case you guys are interested in it. So the first thing we have to do is we have to uninstall our old mirror. So we just unplug the harness that was plugged into the back here, and this is for the auto dimming feature and also for the HomeLink. And then I have a T20 Torx, and I'm going to go ahead and loosen this little screw, and then we can just pull the mirror out. You'll also have to pull the little wire clip up here and we get that out. So looking, this is the old mirror and here's the new one. On the back side, they look pretty much identical. I also want to mention that on the older version on the mirror with the compass, that this harness will be located in a different area. But you can see here, these things are pretty much exactly the same. HomeLink buttons are all in the same location. The only difference is one has a compass on it. Installation is pretty simple. We're just reversing the order. So, same hook and everything, T20 again. So for those of you that just want compass, you're pretty much done, you can plug this in. However, for those of you that would like to get the HomeLink to work, these pin locations are actually wrong for this particular unit. So when you get your unit, hopefully it has the pins for it, double check the location. I have to move the constant wire down one. Now, I learned from my mistake, so I decided to try to depin this guy. It's incredibly hard to depin it. The pin is so embedded into the harness. So here is the pin. I was able to depin it because I'd rather sacrifice the spare plug and see how it's constructed and how it's going to work, as opposed to, you know, trying to pick away at that thing. Because you will, if you're not familiar with depinning, I work with electronics and I'm not that great at depinning. You need a really small fine tool pick set to do it. And you can see here is the little end. The problem was with this particular plug, unlike aftermarket plugs, it's so embedded in here. And you need like the smallest tool. Like I even tried like a sewing needle to get in there to get it out. I couldn't. I had to destroy the plug. So if you don't want to go this far to doing depinning, what I would do is the plug that they typically give you, leave it intact, and what you can do is you can cut the wires here, resolder it, shrink tube and tape over it. I'm still going to have to solder it anyways, so you can pick how you guys want to add that pin to that harness. Luckily, pinning it is a lot easier. So same thing, where all you have to do is take a pick to the side here. So you'll see some white there. This retainer clip or this lock pin or this lock will not come out all the way. It goes around the whole thing. So just raise it enough so it pops out, and you can push your harness that you depinned, if you choose to do it this way, and place it in here. I'm going to leave this wire here. It doesn't seem to do anything for the mirror, so we're just going to leave that there. But I am going to wire this to that. So I will have to cut this back a bit and solder onto that, and then I'll have to retape it nicely or some sort of TechFlex or shrink tube solution afterwards. Okay, so our connection is all done. I have pretty much done the bare minimum. So What I did was I soldered the line on the new pin to the constant line. Now, if you want to be really safe about it, what I recommend doing is that constant line that's originally on the car, I would cut it, terminate it, and leave it there. That way you can always reverse it in case you want to put the old mirror back on. But I'm also willing to bet, I can't confirm, but I'm willing to bet that the circuit trace inside for the new mirror just goes to nothing, while on the old mirror, they just change it that way, I guess, that if you ever decide to buy this mirror, you just can't swap it easily. Like, I just don't understand why they wouldn't make the constant the same across the board. Why would you move it up one pin? But, you know, engineers can do whatever they want, so we just have to understand what they're doing. So to recap on this plug, the black and red is accessory, and then the next pin location in the middle is ground. Those did not have to be moved over in this car. And then I reused the black and white off the old harness, off the FX35, and that is our new constant, while the old constant was one pin above it. And we'll look at it again on our sacrificial plug. So looking from the wire side, so this is the pin side, this is the wire side. Top right is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6 is the black and red. Empty 7, 8 is ground, 9, 10, and these were the constant wires. And it's just the constant wire that you have to mess with. Okay, everything is plugged in. You can go ahead and test for operation. So we have compass, and now to verify HomeLink works, when you push any of these home buttons, the 1, 2, and 3, the green LED will go to red. That means that the new wire that you put in into the plug is getting power to the HomeLink system because it runs off the battery. So either if you didn't put the pin in all the way, if you decide to do the D-pin route, then you'll have to go back and double check that. Or if you decide to cut the harness and wire up all the color, wire up all the pigtails off the car to the new harness, you might have gotten the location incorrect. So there you guys have it, a relatively easy install. The only thing you have to do is really mess around with pins. It's not hard work, but it's very delicate fine-tune work to make sure you don't wreck the plug. So it requires a lot of patience. That's where people I can see getting frustrated really easily. But I didn't have to modify any physical hardware. The mirror just goes right on. I just had to move over one pin. If you didn't care about the HomeLink, you just wanted the compass, you could just plug it in, you'd be done with it. But we go between several locations, and the fact that the HomeLink has three separate buttons, it is a nice convenience feature. I like to have it working. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button, and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus, with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section, and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.